Hello student, so today we are going to learn our fifth chapter. The chapter name is Formatting in Excel. So in our previous chapter, we are going to study how to creating the electronic worksheet using the Microsoft Excel and to perform the various editing operation as to make the changes in it and when needed. Okay, so Microsoft Excel used to enter the various types of data values in the worksheet like text, number, dates, etc. So, which are represented with some default format set by the Microsoft Excel. But the Excel offers the various text and number formatting features which helps to make our worksheet more presentable and readable. So now, we learn these formatting features in Excel for the better representation of data values. Okay? So let's begin with this. So, in Excel worksheet, the data values which are entered in a cell are organized in the form of rows and column. And the mainly two types of data values are entered in it, text and number. Also, the Excel uses some default character formatting alignment to show these values in the cell. So, moreover, the number values are represented with some general formatting which make it difficult to understand. What does that simple number values represented in it? So, the another problem is which we face while adding the data in the worksheet in the length of data values which many a time exceed the cell width and making only the sum part of the data visible in the cell. Okay, so that's why the Excel provide the various formatting feature to handle such types of problems and many more. So let's begin to learn this feature for making the perfect worksheet. So let's get started. Okay. So first, adjust the column width. Okay. So look at here. This is our Excel worksheet. So when we using the Excel to entering the text data, every time we faced one problem, means when we enter the values exceed the default column width in the cell, only the part of that value is displayed in the cell. Means, so in this way, look at here. I write my name, full name. Then, in the second column, I write mobile number. So look at here, these full values is not displayed here. When we adjusting some column width, our whole data will be displayed. Okay, means the default column width in Excel is 8.43. Means that which allows the maximum 8 character data values in the cell within the standard font setting. Okay, so you can adjust the column width to fit the long entries in the cells. Okay, for example, in this way. When we enter the long entries, you have to adjust the column width. So the first is adjusting the columns width. Okay, so many time we face. In the Excel worksheet, we are going to face one problem. Means when we enter the values exceed a default column width in the cell, only the part of that values will be displayed in the cell. Okay. In this way, so look at here. Here the names, only the default column width data will be visible, but the other cell data is not displayed here. Okay, means the default column width in Excel is 8.43, means that size which allows the maximum 8 character of data values in the cell within the standard font setting. Okay. So now we're going to adjust the column width and to fit the long entries in the cell. Okay, so there are the two way to adjust the column width. Okay, means first to change the column width manually and the second to set the column width a specific size. Okay, so first look at here the mouse pointer. Okay, so you have to just drag it towards the left or right to adjust the column width as we needed. Okay, in this way, look at here. So it's here, whole data will be displayed. Also, in another way, we can adjust the column width, means directly to set some specific size. Okay, so firstly we have to just select the column whose width will be changed. So I select this column, okay, and then click on the home tab. In the home tab, here the cell group, here in that cell group the format option, here choose this format option. Look at here, under the format option it has a cell size section. That cell size section to option here row height and the column width. So we have to change the column width, so click on this option. Immediately the column width dialog box will be appear here. So by default the column width is 8.43. okay, so we going to change it 15. Okay, look at here in this way. Okay, means you can manually change their width and also specify some size. So next is adjust the row height. Okay, so means data values enter in a cell with a large font size, automatically to adjust the row height and to fit the values within the cell boundary, we accommodate the value with some standard size. Okay, means the 12 feet. So this is our row. Also we can change the two-way row height in the manually, and also we can going to set the specific size in this way. You have to just bring the mouse pointer in a row header and drag it. So look at here. So in this way the row height is changed. Okay, also you can change by using some specific size, like in this way. Click on the home tab. In the home tab, cell group here, click the choose the format option and click the row height. Immediately the row height dialog box will be appear here. So you have to just enter the new row height. So I enter the 23 and okay. Okay, means you can change the row height in two way, by using manually using the mouse pointer and by using some specific size. You have to just write a specific size and increase the row height. So in this way you can adjust the column width and also adjust the row height. So the next is number formatting. So the most of the data values enter in a worksheet are of the number type, means the Excel provides the various number formatting option to change the appearance of numeric data without affecting their values. Means by default the values are displayed in a general format. Okay, so now we're going to learn how to change the default number formatting. Look at here, the English, Math, Science and SST, this whole data in a form of number type, right? So first select the cell to be formatted in this way, select it, then click on the home tab. In the home tab, here one group number, look at here, this is the general data. When we click on the drop down button, the list of number format is available here. So look at here, this is the symbol of currency, this is the symbol of percentage, this is the comma, means this comma is display the value of cell with the thousands separators. Okay, then these are the decreased decimal and increased decimal. Okay, so we're going to use this for number formatting. Okay, so click on the general drop down button and choose the more number format option. Immediately the format cell dialog box will be appear here. So look at here, here the categories: general, number, currency, accounting, date, time, percentage. So when we choose the currency, this whole data will be formatted in currency. Okay, when we click date, this whole data will be converted in a date. Okay, when we click on this percentage, this whole data will be converted in a percentage. Okay, so as that we need that category, we can select it and apply it. So I choose the currency and okay. So look at here, in this way the whole data will be formatted. Also you can change here the currency, okay, dollar, euros, in this way. Next is aligning the cell values. Okay, so select the data in this way, then click on the home tab. In the home tab, the number group here, click on the general drop down button and choose the more number format. So aligning the cell means the values in the cells are aligned according to their data type, means the numbers are aligned to the right side and text values get aligned to the left side of the cell by default. Okay, but this default alignment can be changed if that you need it. So in this way, alignment, okay, text alignment, here the option left, center, right, field, justify. Okay, so I choose left and the vertically, bottom, top, right, okay, center, center. Look at here, in the text control there are the three options. First, so wrap text means wrap the text exceed the cell limited to the next line by increasing the row height. Then shrink to fit means reduce the font size and to fit the text within the cell boundary. And the last is merge cell. So the merge cell means create a single large cell by merge the selected consecutive cells. Okay, so look at here, the numbers goes in a right side. In this way the numbers are aligned in a left side. In this way you can align the cell values. Also, so look at here, in the home tab, alignment group here, by using that alignment group you can also set the horizontal as well as the vertical cell alignment. So in this way, look at here, left alignment, center alignment, right alignment, okay, these are the intent, increase intent and decrease intent. These are the top align, bottom align and center align. Okay, and look at here, the two option is wrap text and merge and center. Look at here, merge and center, merge cross, merge cell and unmerge cell. Okay, in this way you can also change the data position, center, left, right, top, bottom. Okay, in this way. So look at here, the student database, if you want to merge this cell, select it and click on the merge and center option. Look at here, the whole cell is merged and this data will be come to in a center position. Okay, in this way. So thank you student watching this video very carefully. If you like my video, so subscribe my channel and press the bell icon, means my new uploaded video gives a notification to you. Thank you all dear student.